And now here we are with the GAC M8, a luxury minivan that can comfortably sit 7 that's there to entice you to enjoy the ride. With a ride like this, you're not just shown what it's like to go in style, you're also shown what it's like to arrive in elegance. With this GX Master variant priced at around 3,948,000 Philippine pesos, this luxury minivan is set to show you how the good life can be achieved in so many ways. For this episode, let me show you around, and after all of that, let's take it for a drive. From the moment you look at the front of the GAC M8, you can really tell that there's a distinction about this van. Take a look at the M8 from the outside, and what you're looking at is a van that looks like it's been cut straight out of a diamond. This diamond look that this car carries does go well with the lion-like front grille and the awakening eye LED lights that this ride carries. There's a large windscreen up on front, which goes well with the lion-like front grille that you have. What you'll also like with your front grille is that the camera and the front sensors are properly integrated to go well with the overall look of the car. And in retrospect, when you look at the M8, one of the things that you'll also enjoy about this ride is that as much as it's good looking, it's also very easy to drive. Time to take a look at what's under the hood of the GAC M8. Now, what you have for this luxury minivan is a 2-liter gasoline engine at a front-wheel drive, which gives you 248 horsepower and 400 newton meters of torque. You also have an 8-speed automatic transmission here, which goes well with the front-wheel drive system that you have. Now, you gotta consider that this ride also weighs at around 2.1 tons, give or take. And when you look at it with the overall suspension that you have for this car, it actually does give you a very comfortable ride quality despite its weight. What you'll also enjoy about the M8 is that you have 3 drive modes, namely Eco, Comfort, and Sport, which gives you the best drive experience possible. Now, estimated fuel economy figures for the GAC M8 is around 6 kilometers per liter in the city and 13 in the highway. If you were to look for benchmarks for the GAC M8, the closest that you would have would be the Toyota Alphard. Now, it's got the same numbers in terms of dimensions, but that's where the comparison ends between the two vans. For the GAC M8, what you have here is a continuation of the diamond cut design that it carries here in the side, and what you'll also like are the wheels. Take a look at this. Now, it's got Michelin tires. Compared to other GAC cars like the M-Zoom, it's pretty normal in that sense. But what you'll like are the wheel designs that you have here. It's chrome, but with the chrome is your center caps. Believe it or not, those center caps actually stay upright no matter how fast you're going. Pretty similar compared to other premium European brands. What you'll also enjoy is that you have large windows here, which gives you plenty of visibility both as driver and as passenger. Take a look at the back of the M8, and this is what the van looks like from the rear. Now, one of the things that you'll notice is that you have a chrome accent here in the middle to go with your LED taillights. Now, if you're gonna be wondering where your rear windscreen wiper is, it's actually properly placed right here under the spoiler, which gives it a nice and minimalist look overall for the back. Now, in terms of cargo capacity for the GAC M8, there's actually 3 ways for you to open your rear door. First things first is that there's a physical button beside your steering wheel on the left side. There's also a button on your key fob. And lastly, the most convenient way is pushing this button down below. And what that does is it gives you so much space even with the third row seats in place. Now, I brought an example here just for your visual reference, but this is basically the length of a golf club, typically a driver, something I've used before. And as you can see, there's enough length here for one driver. Now, that's a good amount of width for a van. But if you're gonna be needing even more space for the back of your M8, what you'll also enjoy is the idea that you could be able to fold these third row seats properly and easily. Just pull this tab down and push this tab up. And as you can see, the seat goes all the way up. And doing just that gives you so much space to fit more items here in the back and also still have the capacity to be able to sit 4 people comfortably here in the back of the M8. Now, if you do need to put these seats back into position, you'll also like the idea that it's also very, very easy to put back. As you can see, just pull these 2 tabs down below and the seats are ready to go back into place. All things considered, it's a pretty comfy ride.